I've been to a good share of many different university towns throughout the year. Starting off in Ann Arbor, Michigan, where University of Michigan is, also East Lansing, where Michigan State University is, and also going to do the video in Stanford University. But anyway, here one, this is Scott, and we're live here at Oakland University. This is actually the university I actually graduated from about 4 years ago. So it's very excited to be here right now. Get to show you around the campus a little bit. Because I spent like 4 or 5 years here. It was a great experience. And as you can tell, it's a kind of an overcast day right now, although the cold front just came through. I actually tried starting this video, I think 15, 20 minutes ago, and the cold front was coming through and the winds was getting really windy. And actually, it looks like that sign even blew over from earlier too. But yeah, let's head into the university and let's go check it out. And we made it into this is one of the main parking lots here at Oakland University. Although there's parking lots all over the campus. However, as any OU student or alumni would tell you, the parking here can be monotonous and insane especially during the fall and winter semesters. It can be a challenge parking here. Thankfully though, within the past few years or so, they actually introduced a free bus shuttle throughout the campus, so you can park further out, as they've built many new parking lots, even parking structures, so that way you can easily get across campus. And with it not being as nearly as large as the University of Michigan or Michigan State, you can pretty much just park somewhere and then pretty much leave your car for the day while you're here at the university. But yeah, from this parking lot there, we can see quite a bit of the whole western part of the campus. Got the foundation halls and also the Oakland Center, as we'll get over there shortly. And then right over there, that is the Human Health Building. That was built back in 2012. And that's where the School of Nursing and the School of Health Sciences are currently housed. And a little sentimental fact, I remember my grandfather, because they don't live he didn't live too far away from the university. I remember him talking about this building as he was driving by it, as it was under construction. And the building was completed the same year he unfortunately passed away. But Oakland University has been around since 1957, as it was founded by Alfred and Matilda Dodge Wilson. They actually lived over at Meadowbrook Hall over in the eastern part of the campus. Actually, that's where I'll end the video. I'll show the exterior of the building. Won't be able to go in because I don't think photography or video recordings allowed in there. But they actually first built basically a satellite campus for Michigan State University, as this used to be called MSU Oakland, until about 1963, when eventually became Oakland University. And speaking of my grandfather, he actually took some engineering classes over here at Dodge Hall, which we'll see later in the video. And it was around the time when Oakland split off from MSU. And we made it to North Foundation Hall and South Foundation Hall. These were the very first building which was built here on the campus, dating back to 1959, pretty much the year the university first opened to students. And the reason why I say building is because it actually used to be one building called Foundation Hall. However, in the early 2000s, as there used to be a building like in between connecting the two, they actually took down the old mill building when they were building the extension of the Oakland Center, which is the center of the main center of campus life here at OU. And now it's basically North Foundation Hall. We got the classrooms, you also have admissions and the financial aid department in there. And also with it being homecoming and reunion weekend, it's also you can also do some campus tours. And then there's South Foundation Hall, which I actually go in there briefly because I think they keep that open during the daytime hours at least. That's primarily classrooms. But yeah, both buildings been around since 1959. But yeah, we're in the South Foundation Hall right now. It's pretty quiet. There's not too many classes that go on Saturday, but there are some classes. We can even peek in one of the rooms too. This is like a regular sized classroom. As you can tell, the class sizes aren't, for the most part, aren't that large, which is pretty nice about OU. You get a lot of student-faculty interaction. And there's three floors total in here. Let's head back out.
But yeah, I've been in the South Foundation Hall. I've had a lot of classes in there, and there's been a lot of great memories where I actually got to also take classes, take exams, and also hang out with friends as well.
Anyway, we're here at the Oakland Center.
But yep, the Oakland Center is actually, as I mentioned just a little bit ago, it's the main center of campus life here at OU. It's been around since 1959, however,
this building, part of the building, looks pretty new. That's because this is a new addition that was built in 2003 with the state-of-the-art banquet rooms at the second floor and also a lounge area in here. And we made it inside and got different computers that students can use if they don't have their own laptop or smartphone or any portable device connecting to the web. Got a TV over there too, although it's off right now. I've seen a lot of sport events on those TVs when I was attending classes here. And yeah, it's like, this has even surprised me a little bit. Yeah, Cafe O'Bears, which is like the old coffee shop that was here, totally changed. Just even the past year because I occasionally come back here to see what's new at the university. But yeah, this is totally new. But yeah, it's like, and yeah, this is like the little lounge area that's kind of a part of Cafe O'Bears. But yeah, the bakery is closed on the weekends, but yeah, remember this, especially the second half of my time here at OU, this was where my friends and I hung out a lot, where we used to work on homework and just watch like YouTube videos and different things like that. But yeah, a lot of new furniture in here. Yeah, this looks so much different. And here at the Oakland area, as you can tell, the building looks a little bit older. This is the older building that's been here since same time as the foundation halls, but yeah, this is the Pioneer Food Court, and it actually did a big time renovation even this past year. It's actually a little fun fact, I tried to film this video back in May, but a lot of it was under construction, so it's like, I'll wait till the fall semester to come here. But yeah, looks totally different than even when I was attending classes here. It's like there's still the subway and there's the Chick-fil-A Express, but they even have a Panda Express now. They got Moe's Southwest Grill. Although I think Subway's only open on the weekends. But yeah, this is nice. Here we're downstairs and it got the bookstore right over there. You can get your textbooks there and also buy some other OU merchandise as well as like your scan transfer tests. Things like that.
And we made it back out of the Oakland Center, and yeah, as you can tell, we're just came out of the older part of the building. It looks a lot older, this part. Got North Foundation Hall over there, and there's Wilson Hall.
And then also you got the Meadowbrook Theater, and not to be confused with Meadowbrook Hall, and also the Graham Health Center over that area. And then right over there, we have all the different residence halls, all your different dormitories for students who stay on campus. Although OU is notoriously known for being a commuter school, a lot of students do choose to stay on campus, as we have a Vandenberg Hall over there, and then also got other residence halls over there too, like the Hill House and Hamlin Hall. Yeah, let's head over to that bridge to get a great view of the pond over here.
But yeah, very nice bridge and very nice scenery. Oh, a little fun fact. I actually bought this OU hat several years ago from the bookstore.
But great scenery along here, like near the residence halls. And then further out to the east, there's actually some apartments as well that you can stay in as well. And actually, oh, some over there too. All right, we're gonna head back that way, head over, check out some of the other buildings. Yeah, as you can tell, the wind is starting to pick up a little bit because, yeah, the cold front came through not too long ago. But yeah, there's O'Dowd Hall. There's a lot of offices in there as well as, and there's also some classrooms in there too. That's actually one building I had not had to go into very often when I was attending classes here. Maybe it's because I was in... Maybe because I came here for the IT major, maybe. Yeah, here's a new addition that came in last year. I actually came back here last year around this time to check out what's new at the campus. And this is a brand new building called the Elliott Tower. It's about 151 feet high. It's a new clock tower, actually. I think at the top of the top of the hour every 3 hours, actually the bells actually go off in there, and this looks pretty new too. The actually got a little automated fountain right here. That's pretty cool. We got the sports and recreation area over in that area. We'll be coming back toward that area later. Then we have the Oakland Center or South Foundation Hall over there. All right, let's head south, west.
And we're not terribly far from where I started today's video. As you can see, the entrance, at least from University Drive all the way over there. Pepper, I'm in front of Kresge Library, which is the main library here on campus, and we got...
Actually got a remarkable collection of statues called the Saints and Sinners that's right in front. And you can also see the fountains going, too. Although, not really during the winter months, because obviously, in Michigan, it can get cold. But in September, though, and I think even going into October until like the first freeze, yeah, they'll keep the fountains going, which makes it a very nice environment. All right, let's head into Kresge Library briefly. But as it is a library, we'll have to be very quiet.
We made it to the library. They got different floors in here. You got like books on the third floor, and we're on the top floor right now. You can see like journals and newspapers. And also a great view. You can see the arena over there. But you spend a lot of time up here working on a lot of homework assignments and studying for exams. But I really enjoy the view from up here too.
I always made it out of the library. I didn't really want to film much at all in there, because there actually were students in there doing some studying and working on homework. So I want to give them some respect a little bit. So,
but anyway, yeah, the fourth floor has all the different like journals, periodicals. Third floor has a lot of books, and then there's also a lot of computers on the second floor, and actually the university help desk for technology is actually on the second floor as well. Then over here we have three separate buildings where they have a lot of different classrooms and offices for some of the different departments, especially like in the math and science department. We got the Dodge Hall of Engineering right over here. It's been around since the early 60s, and That was the building I spent a lot of time in for my degree in information technology. As we had a lot of classes in there, went to a lot of computer labs in there. However, after I graduated a few years ago, in the past year, they moved everything over to the new engineering center, which we actually will check that out later in the video. But we have three, so we'll check out really quickly, like all three buildings, although not really too much to see inside. But we have the Dodge Hall right there, and then over there is Hannah Hall. We'll get a better view over on the other side of this tree. And here's Hannah Hall. This actually was named after John Hanna, who actually was a former president at Michigan State University, and actually saw a statue of John Hanna over at Michigan State University back in March when I did a video over in East Lansing. So it's pretty cool how both videos actually connect in a way. And speaking of connecting, the three buildings, Dodge Hall, Hanna Hall, and the Mathematics and Science Center, which used to be called the Science and Engineering Building, in a way, they're all connected together in a way. So we'll check out some quick points of interest inside, but probably not for too long. We'll probably head right back outside shortly.
Yeah, you can tell that's been there for a while, but probably there's been no phone in there for years, probably because of the gloriness of cell phones. Yeah, but we're in Hannah Hall. You can see one of the chemistry labs in there.
And we briefly went back outside, and we're in front of the Mathematics and Science Center. The building, which, as I said earlier, was founded as the Science and Engineering Building, was around since 1997 when the building was built, and then was renamed the Mathematics and Science Center actually this year. And the reason is because all the different science departments and mathematics departments are inside this building. Actually, even when I was attending classes here, I actually had a lot of math classes in this building. And then we got the brand new parking structure over there. And then, yeah, the new engineering center's over there. We'll be heading over there next. But yeah, probably in the next segment, because I'm probably not going to be filming anything in Dodge Hall or in the Mathematics and Science Center.
Yeah, really quick, I'm still in the Mathematics and Science Center. But yeah, these classrooms, they almost look new. It's hard to say though, but regardless, still a little bit of a larger class size, but pretty nice though.
All right, we just got out of Dodge Hall and also the Mathematics and Science Center, and we're in front of the brand new Engineering Center. This was built literally finished a year ago. This is where the School of Engineering and Computer Science has moved to. It used to be in Dodge Hall, but as the building is on the small side and they had to put other departments in there, they built a building just for engineering and computer science and IT students. And I will admit, I actually took a tour here last year when it around the time it opened, and I'm a little jealous because we didn't have these state-of-the-art rooms for any of the IT labs when I was attending classes here. Well, let's head inside and check out a couple of the different areas.
Yeah, man, inside I can even see, look down, some of the students working on some of their engineering projects. This is pretty cool. And they also have brand new state-of-the-art classrooms as well. Oakland Robotics. They're building some robots down there. Yeah, I mean, the top floor. Here we have some of the IT labs. We got the network and security lab where they can do their different experiments in labs. Learn about information security as well as configuring network topologies. So you can work with routers and switches in here. Yeah, it was pretty cool too on each of the different floors. They got these different little working areas and actually use this little wall divider to separate the two halves if you wanted to. Then you're right over there, we have the actual computer lab for the SCCS. Yeah, I gotta say, this is a very nice building. They've done a great job with it. You can see all the different engineering labs and also some of the computer labs for the computer science and information technology students on this floor. But also, what's cool too, we get a great view. You can see the world headquarters for Chrysler over there. And of course, we got College Hall and the Mathematics and Science Center over there. And then if you look all the way out that way, you can actually see the Renaissance Center for downtown Detroit from here. All right, let's head back outside. We're gonna head over toward Elliott Hall and Varner Hall.
Yeah, we're back outside, and yeah, that engineering center is really, really nice. It's really state of the art. So, as I said earlier, I'm a little jealous I didn't get a chance to take classes in there, but it wasn't finished constructed until about a year ago. But anyway, we're back outside briefly. We got Varner Hall over there. That's like the main building for the School of College Arts and Sciences, which is actually the largest college within Oakland University. And they also have like a recital hall in there as well. And then right over there, so yeah, right behind me, is built in the year 2000 is Elliott Hall. It's home to the School of Business and Information Technology. Let's just say they're taking care of business. And ladies and gentlemen, Bogma Turnover Drive. All right, never mind. I'm just acting weird. All right, let's continue.
Yeah, we got all the different classrooms along in here. They're at the front of Elliott Hall. You can look outside from here. And yeah, the Oakland University is a very nice university. As I said earlier, I've attended here from like 2006 to 2011. It's when I graduated with the Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, and really enjoyed. Yeah, I better stop, because I think there's something going on over there, so I'll stand over here. Yeah, really enjoyed attending this university when I was here. Had a great environment, got to hang out with a lot of friends, and also with the classrooms, with the class sizes being as small, I was able to interact with the faculty and the professors a lot, so I was able to really learn from them and get a great learning experience.
All right, let's head back outside.
Really quick, we're here in Varner Hall. Got the recital hall right there, and got the studio theater. Also, there's a lot of involvement with dance in here as well.
Now we just came out of Varner Hall, as you can tell right behind me. And right in front of us is the Carlotta and Dennis Pauley Hall. This is the School of Education and Human Services is inside there. And also on the lower level, there's the Lowry Early Childhood Center, too. That building has been around since 2004. It's one of the newer buildings, but of course not as new as the Engineering Center.
But yeah, the building's actually keeping a shelter from the winds a little bit.
But yeah, as I was mentioning a little bit ago, Oakland has a very beautiful campus, and it's a great, great learning environment here. So it's definitely one university I would recommend attending, whether you're here for your undergraduate studies or even if you go into like a graduate program. And we made it to the Athletic Center, or areas here at Oakland University. We got one of the baseball diamonds down there. And also got areas for soccer as well. And then right over there is the... Let's move over there, or maybe it'll be a little bit less breeze, because I'm practically talking into the wind right now. All right, here's a lot better spot, and a little bit shelter from the wind, so you might be able to hear me a little bit more. But anyway, this is the recreation center. Because when attending classes here, you can get really stressed out with a lot of homework, labs, and or just campus life in general. This is a great place just to unwind. They got a track, they got basketball courts, fitness center. You also can get a massage here as well. They also have an Olympic-sized swimming pool. Yeah, unfortunately, because I'm not a student, probably not gonna really be able to show inside there. But to check out all the different buildings more than what I've been showing, yeah, definitely take a campus tour here. Oakland University does give a lot of great campus tours to where you can definitely check out more than what my video is showing. And we made it to the Athletic Center, which is right next to the Recreation Center. This is also known as the arena. This is where Oakland plays all their basketball and volleyball games. Also got the aquatic center, to where you can see like swim meets as well. So again, see all the different basketball games here. As a matter of fact, Oakland's basketball team actually has made it into the NCAA tournament a couple times within the past decade. Why does it feel like there's somebody something breathing at me right now? Oh, that's why. Yep, in 2006, the same year I first started attending classes at Oakland University, from 2006 to 2011, they actually built this statue of this grizzly bear. As Oakland University is, their mascot's the Golden Grizzlies. But yeah, pretty cool statue. And then as you can tell, we're back at O'Dowd Hall, we have Elliott Tower, so we've literally made a circle. And got the apartments over there, and all right, before we close out today's video here at Oakland University, we're gonna head over to the east part of the campus, and although we won't be able to go inside to film or anything, I'll definitely show the exterior of Meadowbrook Hall. I'm glad I got a chance to hear the bells in action here at the Elliott Tower. That was pretty cool. Now let's head over to Meadowbrook Hall to finish our video here. And last but not least, we made it over to Meadowbrook Hall. We're at the east part of the campus right now. A little disappointed right now because, yeah, actually, you can't really film anywhere on the grounds of Meadowbrook Hall. So I'm basically filming from out here. But you can see a part of the mansion. It's been around since 1926 to 1929 was when it was first built. It's in the Tudor Revival style, and this is where Matilda Dodge Wilson actually stayed. This was originally like their summer house, and then they moved out here. This was even before the university came to be. But yeah. There's always a chance that maybe in a couple of years or so I might be able to try to do a separate video maybe. I might have to pay like a filming fee or something, possibly. But yeah, we're in the eastern part of the campus right now, and there's a lot of golf course. There's a pretty big golf course out in this area. And then the Meadowbrook Pavilion is actually just to the north of here, where they also occasionally do concerts. And also it's where the OU commencement takes place. That's actually where I had my graduation 4 years ago. Yeah, Oakland University has a great campus for the students and also for just people just to check around, including over at Meadowbrook Hall. Except this is one university I definitely recommend attending if you're looking to go into undergraduate or graduate studies. Except, thank you for watching today's video here at Oakland University, and this is Scott, or the Scott Man, signing out.